on this Transfiguration of the Lord Sunday. Greetings. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit be with you one and all. Again, welcome to our virtual worship service. Come with us now as we go forth in intentional worship of our triune God.
Please join me for our call to worship. The glory of God shines like a consuming fire. We have seen the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. The voice of God thunders like a mighty storm. Out of the cloud, God speaks. This is my beloved Son. Listen to him in spirit and in truth. Let us worship God. Pray with me, church family. Heavenly Creator, source of all things, seen and unseen, we thank you for everything you have blessed us with. We thank you for just your presence in the midst of our daily comings and goings. We ask that you continue to fertilize our hearts and minds so that we can be open and able to receive your truth at any moment of the day, at any time. And we ask all of this in the mighty, powerful name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Call to confession. The proof of God's amazing love is this: while we were sinners, Christ died for us. Because we have faith in him, we dare to approach God with confidence, in penitence, and in faith. Let us now confess our sins by praying our prayer of confession. God of compassion, have mercy upon us as we confess our sin. In Christ you bring light, yet we still dwell in darkness. Your word offers guidance, but we choose to ignore your counsel. You promise renewal, but we heed not your wisdom. We bow to the gods of this world, choosing to hide from your truth. In your mercy, speak to us again from beyond the clouds of our sinfulness. Dazzle us anew with the light of Christ's love. In your grace, restore and forgive us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. My friends, hear the good news. Our God comes and does not keep silent. God speaks to us with grace and love, saying, "You are my child, beloved." This is the good news of the gospel. So I declare to you, in the name of Jesus Christ, that you are, I am, we are forgiven. Now go and do likewise and be at peace. We turn now to the proclamation of the word portion of our worship service. After the prayer of illumination, our scripture readings for this Lord's Day will be as follows. The Old Testament text comes from the Psalter. It is Psalm 50, verses 1 through 6. That's Psalm 50, verses 1 through 6. And the New Testament comes from the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 9, verses 2 through 9. That's Mark, chapter 9, verses 2 through 9. Pray with me now our prayer of illumination. Speak to us, O Lord our God, and let the fire of your Spirit burn brightly in our hearts. Open our minds to receive the wisdom of the law, the hope of the prophets, and the life of the gospel. Jesus Christ, your living word. Amen.
Today's Old Testament scripture comes from Psalm chapter 50, verses 1 through 6. I will be reading from the NRSV. Listen to the word from God, the acceptable sacrifice, the mighty one. God the Lord speaks and summons the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting. Out of Zion, the perfection of beauty, God shines forth. Our God comes and does not keep silence. Before he is devouring fire and a mighty tempest all around him, he calls the heavens above and to the earth that he may judge his people. Gather my faithful ones who made a covenant with me by sacrifice. The heavens declare his righteousness. The God himself is judge. Selah. This is the end of the Old Testament scripture. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Here now our gospel reading for today, Mark chapter 9, verses 2 through 9. The words of the oldest gospel writer. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. And his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make 3 dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice. This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him. Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. The Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Good morning, children. Today, I would like to speak with you all about how we should always remember Jesus, even when we are afraid or frightened of certain outcomes. Let's start with a common example. I'm sure that there are some foods that you are afraid to try. Why are you afraid to try them? It may be because it tastes bad, or it might be because it's spicy, or may not look like it's good. When I was younger, I could not stand the sight of Brussels sprouts. I did not like how they looked or tasted. There are some foods today that even as a grown-up, I'm often afraid to try. My parents would then explain to me what it was and urge me to try it just to see what would happen. Most of the time, after hearing what they had to say, I would try the food. Now, this did not mean that I automatically liked the food, but I did stop being afraid of it to the point where I could not eat it. Food isn't really all that scary. It's not gonna eat you, right? Also, food gives you the energy to help you grow. Being afraid of something that isn't actually scary is what today's lesson is all about. In it, we heard that Jesus went up to a mountain with a few of his disciples. While he was at the top of the mountain, he spent some time praying, and while he was praying, his clothes were dazzling white, like they were shining. His disciples were very afraid of what was happening. Even though the disciples knew Jesus, once Jesus started to light up, it really scared them. They were so scared by what they were seeing that they didn't know what to say or do. But then the disciples were reminded by God that even when they were afraid, they were supposed to listen to Jesus. That same reminder is true for us too. Today's story reminds us when we are frightened, we are to keep listening to what Jesus taught and said. When we do, Jesus' words will help us know how to face our fear, even when we are afraid. That is the good news for today. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for Jesus who shines with your light and helps us to know what to do even when we are afraid. Help us to always turn to him when we are unsure of how things will turn out. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Father God, we thank you for waking us up this morning to see another glorious day. You are a merciful and loving God. We give you our thanks and praise. Father, we ask that you continue to bless us so that we may continue to bless others. And we thank you for our family and loved ones and friends. And we lift up those who are mourning the loss of their loved ones. Please give them comfort. We ask that you touch with your healing hands those who are dealing with illness or pain. And Father, be the great comforter and friend to those who may be feeling friendless or isolated. Let them know that they are not alone. We pray for our leaders, locally, nationally, and internationally, and we ask that you guide their actions and decisions. And today, Father, is a day designed for love. And as we gather with our loved ones, let us not forget the greatest love, our first love, agape love, the love that you give us freely. And may we show the love of Christ in our daily walk, and may we see the love of Christ in others. May we love ourselves and one another as you, Father God, loves us. And we close by saying the prayer that you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thou art the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
On this Transfiguration of the Lord Sunday, I bid you peace, joy, and love. Before we get started, I want to highlight a couple of announcements. First, in preparation of our annual congregational meeting, which will be held via Zoom on March 13th, Saturday, March 13th at 10 a.m., we'd like for you to get your nominations for elder and deacon to our clerk of session by February 15, Monday, February 15. Second, we will conduct an Ash Wednesday drive-by where you may pick up your communion elements and your Lenten resources. We will have this drive-by on Ash Wednesday, which is February the 17th. It begins at 3 p.m., and it will be in the church parking lot. I hope to see many of you there. And our final announcement is that our Lenten Bible study series begins on Ash Wednesday. The first class is at 8 p.m., and you may contact the clerk of session for the invite information for Zoom. Now to what we're here in this moment for. The sermon for this Lord's Day finds its basis in the gospel lesson, which has already been read. To get us started, hear these words. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice. "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." Listen to him. This morning, for just a little while, I want to speak about listening to God. Listening to God. Pray with me, please. Loving God, in the moments to come, make us mindful of your presence. Creator God, in the moments to come, through your word, lead us out of darkness into your marvelous light. Merciful God, in the moments to come, free us from all the hurt and pain we've carried to this moment with you. All-knowing God, in the moments to come, be present with us so that through your word, we will be made new again, reborn by your grace. Now, God, for as much as without thee we're not able to please thee, mercifully grant that thy Holy Spirit may in all things that follow direct and rule our hearts. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. Amen. Listening to God. In our gospel lesson for today, Peter, James, and John experience a theophany. A theophany, which is defined as an appearance of God. Theophany. You know, Moses experienced a theophany in a burning bush. Elijah experienced a theophany in a still small voice. John the Baptizer experienced a theophany at the River Jordan with Jesus, and he experienced it in a descending dove and a voice from a cloud. I pray today, beloved, that each of you can recall a moment in your life, a moment when your connection with the Creator was such that you experienced a theophany. And in that regard, it is good to remember that God speaks to us. Yes, God speaks to us in the silence, in the rustling of the wind, in the clap of thunder, in the smell of the morning dew, in the sound of our beating hearts, in a baby's smile, in a touch. Yes, God speaks to us in a glance, in a feeling, in a sunset, in an empty cross, in bread and in wine, in a baptismal font. Yes, God speaks to us, not just in words, listening to God. In our gospel lesson, we see God expressing joy and pleasure in Jesus Christ through his transfiguration. We also see bewildered and baffled disciples embedded in a theophany where they are told to listen to Jesus and pay attention to Jesus. Yes, that theophany and those words prove challenging for them then and for us today. You see, listening to God, listening to anyone really does not come easy. To listen is harder than you think. Or to listen, to pay strict attention to another, requires discipline, requires effort. Yes, it requires commitment. Still, there is great value in taking the time to listen. I mean, really listen. For when you listen, you learn. Now, about now, some of you are saying, Reverend Doctor, I hear you. I see where you're going. I see the value in listening. But there is so much unnecessary chatter in the world today. Just to keep my sanity, I tune most stuff out. You know, I turn a deaf ear to most of what I hear. You know, I get that. And I understand it. However, your protest makes my point. Everybody's talking. Few are really listening. So no one learns, no one grows, no one matures, and therefore we remain stuck in a mess of our own making. Have you noticed that when we do decide to take the time to listen, most times we don't listen well. We don't listen attentively. Yes, we listen with half a mind. Half a mind because the other half is thinking about what we're going to say in return. Yes, we are readying our retort. Or we listen with divided effort. You know, while one is talking, the other is texting, looking at a video movie, playing a game, listening to music, whatever. You get where I'm going. You know, I think that part of the problem with listening is that we assign greater value to talking. Yes. We're trained to talk as teachers, salespersons, lawyers, politicians, preachers, and parents. We're trained to talk in order to teach, to persuade, to convince, and to convict. That's just what we do. And it's only after missteps, mistakes, misunderstanding have laid us low, only after we have heard the condemning. You need to learn how to listen. See, that's your problem. You don't listen to anybody. Why? Why won't you listen to me? It's only after we have heard these condemning things. It's only after we have learned and have had to live with the results that we really see the need to listen. You see, it's only through listening that we mature physically, intellectually, emotionally, and spiritually. Beloved, I believe that much of what we're experiencing in the world, our country, our community, our church, our families, is so overwhelming that it makes it hard. Yes, it's so overwhelming that it makes it hard to still ourselves, to slow our minds so that we can give full attention to anyone, anything, ourselves and our God included. Yet, that is what this moment is trying to teach us. It is time for us to still ourselves and really listen. Listen to one another. Listen to our God. You see, when you listen to those you disagree with, you learn. And with knowledge comes compassion, maybe even empathy, and the ability to find common ground while recognizing the humanity in the other. When you listen to those you agree with, you learn, and your relationship matures. Bonds strengthen, love deepens. You get my point? My brothers and sisters in Christ, listening, really listening, takes discipline. Listening, really listening, also takes love. We listen to God because we long to learn from God, to grow and deepen our relationship with God. We listen to those we care about for the exact same reason. And we should learn to listen to those we don't care about for the exact same reason. Henri Nouwen, noted theologian, priest, philosopher, and mystic, said of listening, "Somewhere we know that without silence, words lose their meaning, that without listening, speaking no longer heals." The poet wrote of listening, "His thoughts were slow, his words were few, and never formed to glisten. But he was a joy to all of his friends. You should have heard him listen." Beloved, the takeaway from our mountaintop theophany with Jesus and the disciples is this: listening is important. It is what we're called to do in relationship with God and with one another. The takeaway from our personal theophanies with God should remind us that if we listen to God, if we discern God's will and follow God's instruction, no real harm will befall us and everything will work together for good. And on this Valentine's Day, the takeaway from our most cherished relationship should remind us of how listening to one another affirms, strengthens, and deepens the love that binds. So we close with this challenge. And the challenge is simple. Starting today, will you embrace the discipline of listening? It is my hope and my prayer that you will. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We turn now to the service of giving for this Lord's Day. A big thank you to all of you who have so generously contributed to this ministry. What we have been able to do because of your support has been amazing. Indeed, you cannot be God giving. Little becomes much when you place it in God's hands. Beloved, the God who speaks and summons the earth into being now speaks to us, calling us to bring forth our time, our talent, and our treasure. Please give. Again, thank you for the gifts given to this ministry. Pray with me, please. Gracious God, we acknowledge that all things come from Thee, and is from Thine own that we have given Thee. Mercifully grant that these gifts given on this day will go for the upbuilding of Your kingdom right here on earth as we anxiously await the day of Your magnificent return. It is in the name of Your Son and our Savior, Jesus the Christ, that we pray. Amen.
Please join me for our church concerns and announcements. As always, keep in prayer, keeping your highest thoughts and prayers, those who are recovering from illnesses, as well as those who have experienced a loss in their life. Please keep these people in your prayers. We love our church family, and we stand with you, and we do this through connecting with God in times of distress. On February 17th, we will have a Ash Communion pickup at the Church of the Master. February 17th, Wednesday, is the start of the Lenten season, and we will celebrate by having communion. So you may come by the church at 3 p.m. on February 17th for our Ash Wednesday drive by Lenten Resources. Pick up your communion bits so that we can be prepared to celebrate this season together. Our church bylaws require that we have a congregation meeting, and we will have one during the first quarter of our year. So on Saturday, March 13th, 2021, at 10 a.m., we will have our congregation meeting at that time. Information will be sent closer to that date. It will be a Zoom meeting. Again, information, including the Zoom link, will be sent to you all closer to that date on March 13th. At 10 a.m., we will have a congregation meeting. More information to come. As always, join us at 9 a.m. Call in as we join together as a committed body of believers to pray with each other, to reflect with each other on the power and goodness of God's word. At 9 a.m. Monday through Friday, please call in to the number 712-770-5505, 712-770-5505 with the access code 272-375, 272-375 pound. We do this because we're, as scripture says, where two or more are gathered in Christ's name, there is power, and this is a manifestation of that. You may find all of our information about our virtual services and church happenings on our Facebook and YouTube platforms. You go to YouTube, search Church of the Master Atlanta, you will see all of our virtual services. As well, if you go on Facebook, Facebook.com/COTMATL, you will find a lot of information on virtual services there as well. And as always, every month, we celebrate another round of souls who are taking another trip around the sun. So please join me as we wish the following names a very, very, very splendid birthday celebration. February 1st, Pierre Edwards. February 6th, Nicholas Barringer. February 9th, Darlene Wilford Bay. Happy belated birthday to you. February 18th, Annie Edwards. February 20th, Reverend Paul Roberts, Sr. February 21st, Cynthia Barksdale, and February 28th, Arthur Jones. We wish you a happy birthday month. Please, please always remember that the reason for the season, and keep God first in your life. And we are very happy to announce the anniversary of Ken and Mary Tanner McCain. Celebrated anniversary on February 15th. So happy anniversary to you. And that concludes our church concerns and announcements. Y'all have a blessed week.
A parting word. We'd like to thank our worship leaders for this Transfiguration of the Lord Sunday. Our liturgist, Elder Zettler Clay IV, Kendra Matthews, Elder Kendra Matthews, Prayers of the People, Mr. Nicholas Barringer, Time for Children, Liam Fields, our Old Testament Scripture, our Black History Moment produced by Christian Education. We'd like to thank our virtual musicians, Ms. Esrene Clark and Mrs. Sheila Wheat Harris, and our video producer, Elder Anthony Meadows. Happy Valentine's Day, one and all. Quote a lovely song: what the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. My parting word to you is spread love. Replenish the world's supply by giving of yourself. Remembering to love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, your mind, and your neighbor as yourself. Until we gather again in this virtual space, I want you to go in peace, knowing that God loves you. Jesus died for you. The Holy Spirit is always around to support you and sustain you. I am the Reverend Dr. Cecilia A. Taylor, pastor of Church of the Master Presbyterian Church, located in Atlanta, Georgia. We hope to see you soon.